In this video, we're going to look at elements. All substances, everything in nature, ultimately are composed of substances that we call elements. Elements make up everything. And an element is something that cannot be broken down any further by chemical means. If it is broken down further, it has to be by physical means. And when you do that, it doesn't have any of the properties of that element anymore. It's not that stuff anymore. So if you had gold, pure gold, a bar of it, it would be made up of atoms of just gold, the element gold. And if you broke that up farther and farther, you could get smaller and smaller pieces of gold. But if you had a really, really sharp knife, ultimately you'd get to the point where you just had two atoms of gold attached to each other. You cut them, and now you have an atom of gold on each side. Each of those atoms is the element gold. Now, if you were to break that down any farther, it wouldn't be gold anymore. It'd just be what makes up gold, protons, neutrons, stuff we're going to see later. Now, every element has a name and a symbol. There are some new ones that recently have been discovered, actually, that they are still in the process of naming and giving them symbols. But when they finish doing that, they also will have names and symbols. Now, capitalization is important. When you're writing the symbol for an element, the first letter always has to be capitalized. Always, always, always. If there's only one letter, then it must be capital. If there's two or three letters in the symbol for the element, then the second, and if there's a third, the third letter must not be capitalized. Otherwise, it's just wrong. So here, this on the left right here, this is represents a compound that contains the element carbon, C is carbon, and oxygen, O is oxygen. These are each elements, they're both capital. Now this over here is way different, totally different than this over here. This actually is carbon monoxide, the gas. This is an element, and it has two letters in the symbol for its name, a capital C and then a lowercase o. And this is actually cobalt, a metal, a transition metal. Now, different ways that I've seen people write symbols that are wrong. Remember, the first letter must be capital, so this way of writing Fe, it ends up as iron. So lowercase f, lowercase e is wrong. There's no element with that symbol. That's just wrong. And capital F, capital E, there is no element with the symbol, just an E. And so there's no such thing as this either. Iron, which is Fe, this is the symbol for iron. Capital F, lowercase e. So first letter must be capitalized, any others must not be. Now, the periodic table, which we're going to see in a little bit here, has essentially a list of all the elements that are known to man. These are some of the more common ones, and I'm going to ask you to memorize the names and the symbols for these. And you'll learn others as we go along. It's really easy because most of them, once you start hearing the name, most of them, the symbol gives you the first, part of the name. Al for aluminum, for example. However, there are some in which the name, the symbols, were derived from Latin or Greek words, and these, it's not as obvious. So gold came from the word aurum, and its symbol is Au. Iron is Fe from ferrum, lead from plumbum, and so on. And so memorize these guys. So what you're going to memorize, just the symbols and the names.